Life is like jazz. You never know what comes next.
The premium international airline brand Lufthansa truly believes in the power of content marketing and how it can help create genuine engagement with the consumers by sharing real stories. The brand sees huge scope in digital content and is also open for content partnerships with the OTT players. In a video interview series Republic TV Presents Engage, Michael Knapp, Director B2C Marketing Asia Pacific at the company, talks about the brand's various content initiatives and his views on the content marketing space shaping up in India.
We are in the wrong place.
No. Everything is fine.
Non-stop you. Lufthansa.
How important is branded content and content marketing for the brand to reach out to the consumers in India?
I think it's very important. It's a huge part of the 360 campaign approach that we're having for Lufthansa. And especially in times where we believe that the hard selling times are over. So we want to tell stories and we want to make people resonate with our brand. And then content marketing comes in as a very key point.
What are your major content marketing initiatives?
For our current campaign, Life Changing Places, we teamed up with National Geographic. So we did an offline event last season where we invited the hero of our story. We tell stories in India, and we invited the hero of our story to come and tell his story, and to an audience of travel enthusiasts, of young people interested in travel. We also had a panel discussion there with the key players of the aviation industry and travel industry also make sure and then to bring across their ideas on traveling and their views on travel and inspiration. And this is also a whole part of the offline event, and we also went into social and digital, and we even bring it on our in-flight entertainment soon.
What kind of content formats did the brand plan at various stages of consumer journey funnel for the Life Changing Places campaign?
As a brand, we obviously want to be present in all parts of the funnel. So we look into the upper funnel, the mid funnel, and the lower funnel. For us, the upper funnel is awareness, right? For Life Changing Places, we launched during our campaign period, we launched an awareness part, which was basically, the big campaign, 360 degrees brand campaign, branded content. That was in the upper part, in the upper funnel, for the awareness part. For the mid funnel, we try to inspire people. We want to give them ideas and inspirations for travel. What we did is we launched an so-called inspirational tool where people could use take pictures of their environment, and AI-based technology helped us to create or give them suggestions where in the world they could travel. And then, of course, in the lower funnel, that's sales. And that's what we want to do in the end as well, to make sure that people know us, they're inspired by us, and then they buy our tickets.
What scope of content marketing and branded content do you see on TV, radio, and print medium?
For us, and in my view, basically, is content is more on a digital environment as well, digital and social. Again, it has to be in a 360 campaign campaign philosophy, and you cannot tell a different story in an offline field than you do in an online field. But when it comes to tell inspirational stories, this is the best to do it in on digital and on social. Of course, we sort of bring across our campaign also in other channels, but digital is a key thing basically. TV is for reach, radio is for reach, and this is, I think, for us now, we want to sort of stick to us and to our brand and want to bring our message across. When it comes to content partnerships and content marketing, that's rather in the environment of as I said, like for me, still in the digital environment. But we're always open to explore things. And I think that the mentioned partnership with National Geographic helped us to do that and to take the first steps in this field as well.
India is massively seeing a rise in the number of OTT platforms and their offerings for brands in terms of content. Are you open for content partnerships with OTT players in India?
a clear message, yes, we are. And we are, because I think it's we always try to learn in our campaigns, which we try to explore as well. And as I said, we took the first steps with National Geographic on some other content relation stuff. We partnered with Hotstar, and we take the learnings from there. And now we're looking into what we actually can do more, because I believe that India is such a bustling, such a energetic place, and with cool ideas. And this is where we should definitely look more into.
What kind of content genres can an aviation brand explore other than travel related content?
I mean, we're in the aviation industry, right? So in the end, we want people to sit on our flights and travel. We believe that humans are born explorers, and we want to tackle this exploration gene in everybody to go on a journey, to travel. This is what we do with our campaign, with our storytelling approach. And we believe it's the right way to do so. In the past, we also talked, and what we did as well is we sort of, by telling these stories, we actually take several steps back. It's not us talking, like, look, this is our seat, this is our plane. It's real people's stories that we're telling, because we believe that this is where people can resonate to, and where people, it's plausible, and people can sort of rely to it more than as purely airline and product messages. In the past, we also did different things. For instance, we know how important food is for India. So we had an initiative that people could send in their favorite food recipes to us, and the best one, we had a jury there, and the best one actually made it on board of our flights in our catering. So this is also a different way of tackling stories that we do, basically.
What is the next big thing you foresee that will shape the content marketing space for the brands?
I believe that there will be more different formats. There will be interactive content, more tech-driven, more in a way, things that there were science fiction a few years ago is now will become more visible and more clear to us. I mean, chatbots and stuff were there technology yesterday, or is there now, basically. But interactive content is something that I believe is certainly the truth.
What are the common mistakes you think that marketers make while taking the content route?
In general, I believe that as a brand, you really have to know what you stand for, what your values are, what your visions are, and what your brand core is. I think for a global brand like us, it's certainly challenging to bring that across to all the destinations, all the cities that we're countries that we're dealing in. So you have to know your story, you have to know your DNA. And for us, authenticity is a key thing in our brand. So we want to tell stories that are real. We want to be a brand that is perceived real. And whatever we do and whoever we team up with has to be authentic as well, and has to match our brand DNA as well, and our brand philosophy. It's a perfect match then.
What is the advantage that content marketing brings to the table versus advertising?
With content marketing, you can explore much more. You're faster. You can sort of try different things easier if you find the right partners, I think. And I think it's a perfect way of telling stories. And I know I repeat myself with storytelling, but this is something that we really want to do. And this is what sort of sets us apart from our competitors. And with content marketing, it's a combination of finding the right partner, getting more reach there as well through the partner, like we did with National Geographic.
Republic TV presents Engage, a video interview series brought to you by Buzz & Content.